Welcome back, friends. These are today updates. I have done many changes, but the existing functionality, I have not done anything new. Few things I have done, I'll go to explain. I have completed adding records, adding employees, customers, and vendors, like that update. I have done updating existing vendor, existing customer, existing employee. Also, they can view by ID, view by employee code, customer code, and vendor code. These changes have done. But part of the changes, I have done a lot of code changes. The existing flow itself. Even I have changed the request JSON, employee request JSON, customer request JSON, and the vendor request JSON. Then previously I have used Spring Boot validation framework for validate, but I change it to my own validation. For user flow, for user registration flow, we need to go with our own validation framework. That is the easiest way. I'll go to explain why I change it to my custom validation. These are JSON requests for creating an employee. Here I have given all the sample JSON, creating employee, updating employee, like that customer and the vendor. Okay, previously this JSON request come as a user data in the backend system. User data in the backend system. Now this JSON request come as an employee data if you want to create an employee. If you want to create a customer, the request of that come as a customer data. If you want to create a vendor, the request JSON come as a vendor data. Previously it was user data, I think. Now I changed. See, user private control. I moved everything in user private control. I will tell you later why I moved everything in user private control. This is employee post mapping. The employee post mapping, see the request object is employee DTO. This employee DTO contains user DTO. Like that, vendor DTO contains user DTO, customer DTO contains user DTO. Now, user should have fill this information. Should have filled this information and sent the request to create an employee. Okay. The reason I changed it like this is when I update existing record, I was facing some technical issue while using that kind of request. When I send a user DTO as a request object, I was facing some issues. While updating an employee, while updating a customer, while updating a vendor. My intention is I want to use the same endpoint for creating updating. The same endpoint for creating updating. I was not able to use when I use request object as a user DTO. So that I changed it to employee DTO. Now this post mapping for updating an employee and creating a new employee. Similarly, customer for updating a customer, creating a new customer. Like that, vendor also. Okay. Then, when you look at here, I am using user validator dot validate. Using this validator class, I can validate employee object, customer object, vendor object. The same class I am using for all the places. Same validate method I am using for all the places. Okay, I removed Spring Boot validation framework for user registration, but definitely I'm going to use that same validation framework for some other scenario. The reason I'm using my own validation framework is employee DTO contains user DTO. Inside user DTO, we have an attribute that we need to validate. Those attributes not available here directly. For example, this first name, last name, everything is not available directly. It's available inside a user DTO. So I'm facing some difficulties to validate those fields which is in the sub object. User DTO is a sub object, right? I want to validate those fields inside a sub object. That is not possible, I think, in the Spring Boot validation. So that I removed those things and I replaced with my own custom validation. When you look at the validate method, The validate using a generics. Okay, generics you can pass any type of object here, any type of classes here. Here I'm checking what is the instance of the type of class we are passing. If it is employee, I'm validating employee related here. Here I'm validating vendor related. Here I'm validating customer related. Also, here I'm calling on validate user. Validate user is a generic method for three type of validation. Generic method for employee, vendor, and customer. Validate user is a generic for employee, vendor, customer. Because employee detail holding the user object, customer detail also holding a user object, vendor detail also holding user object. For that, I create a separate private method for validate. After validation, whatever validation error coming from here, those errors I'm assigning here. Then I'm validating employee specific field. I'm validating employee specific field. If there is a validation error, I'm adding the same validation message. Okay, the validation message is a list. Okay, I'm adding that itself. As of now, employee specific field is a full name. Okay, in future, definitely we'll go to add some specific field to employee. In that time, I'll go to add those field validation here. Like that, vendor also, like that, customer also. Okay, this is the validator class for employee, vendor, and the customer. If validation method does not have anything, there is no validation. If validation message is contains some value, that we are assuming that there is some validation error. So that I am throwing the invalid input exception. This message will display in the client side. I will show you the demo while explaining exception handling in the video. The probably I will going to post in the next video. Okay. So these are the changes. Apart from in the database, I have added a password field in the user table. If you want to see my old code, I have created separate branch building system backup 3_11_2020 version 1. This is the new branch. In this branch, I have all old code. The latest code available in the main branch. Whatever code I'm explaining you, that is available in the main branch. My previous old code available in this building system underscore backup branch. Okay, if you want to go on and take a look, my old code. Okay, then add update is I explained. Then view. Yeah, I have done view to view the employee details, customer detail, and the vendor detail. This ID is a path variable. ID is a path variable we have to pass as part of our endpoint request URL. We need to pass ID. This ID could be either customer primary key or customer code or customer code. Here what I am saying here, view by ID or code. View by ID or code. The database, in the case of employee, we have a employee code and a ID. These both are unique, right? Also in the customer also we have a, we don't have customer record here. We have only employee. Okay, like that customer also we have a customer code and an ID. The both are unique. In the case of vendor, we also vendor code as well as ID. The both are unique. We can view that particular entity object by passing code or ID. Okay. Client should pass this ID in the request path. This ID either customer code or a customer ID. Okay. I have created one class called customer service. Instead of customer service, we have one method called find customer. The find customer taking this ID as an input parameter. If ID prefixed with SUS, if the ID is prefixed with SUS, that is customer code. Okay. If ID is not prefixed with SUS, that is a customer primary key. Okay. That is logic here. If a customer ID prefixed with SUS, I'm calling find by customer code, passing this customer code. For that customer code, the customer data assigned here. If the ID is not prefixed with the CUS, it's a definitely primary key. So that primary key I am passing find by ID from the repository object. The respective ID is customer assigned here. Then I am constructing the response object. Response message equal to response, new response message is customer not equal to null. What I am doing, I am mapping this customer to customer DTO. Okay. Then I am setting the customer DTO as my response class type to the response message. This response message display in our client side. I am sending this response message. I am setting in the response entity. This response entity holding the response message. The response message holding the customer DTO class with the status code 200. Very similarly, employee vendor. Okay. Please take a look. Okay, change it to Spring Boot validation. That is also completed. Spring Boot centralized exception handling. I will explain that in next video. Okay. I don't want to take more than 15 minutes video, but sometime I'm taking even 30 minutes video. I'm stopping this video now. The next video I'm going to show only demo. How to create an employee, how to update the employee, like that customer window, then how to view the records by code, but ID. Then I'm going to start explaining how I implemented Spring Boot centralized exception handling. Okay, until then, bye bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel, please subscribe it, share this video to your friend circle, click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.